Is this governance or is this just plain gerrymandering? So much speculation about why politicians just love subdividing their political kingdoms. The latest, of course, which we talk about tonight in Camarines Sur, which may just have a new province carved out of it called Nueva Camarines, and Quezon province, which may soon give birth to Quezon del Norte and Quezon del Sur. Join us as we go behind the scenes of the political battlefields. I'm your host, Pia Ontiveros. This is Strictly Politics. Join us in this segment, in this first segment of the show. We have Camarines Sur Congressman Luis Villafuerte and Arnulfo Fuentebella. Okay, that's Congressman Villafuerte and Congressman Fuentebella. Good evening,
good
sirs.
Evening.
Thank you
good
for
evening.
Being here. Of course, you're here because El Rey, your son.
My favorite son.
Your favorite son. Yeah, we'll get into that in a little while. Magiging personal din tayo. But a few weeks back, he was here on the show because
I saw that.
Oh, you saw it? You were watching?
I was watching.
Oh, okay.
Somebody called me by phone and said, yeah. Hey,
yung anak niyo,
El Rey is on deck.
Okay. All right. So you're here now to talk about this. Let's begin first with the status of the bill. No, there are two House bill numbers, eh, no? Yung 4728 and 4820. So this was the old, yung 4728, yung lumang bill.
The original bill, and when amendments are introduced, mm-hmm. it gets a new number.
That's
so
why it's
it becomes a substitute
now.
Bill.
Okay. Very briefly, sir, can you fill us in? What were the amendments that were introduced to make it 4820?
Well, I introduced many amendments. First, I distinguished the governmental powers and assets and the strictly what we call as proprietary functions of a local government.
Mm.
Assets that are strictly governmental are transferred to a new province at no cost,
mm-hmm.
while exercise of proprietary powers through acquisition of economic enterprises,
mm-hmm.
Irrespective of where the location is, even if it's in the new province, that remains in the mother province of Camarines Sur.
Oh, ganon.
Yes.
Okay. And why did you do that? Why did you?
Because this is an economic endeavor, self-liquidating. Purportedly revenue generating, mm-hmm. and if the new province wants to buy it, it must offer a fair price to it.
Mm-hmm. What is it? What are you saying?
For example, there was a in Caramoan, which will be in the new province,
mm-hmm.
There was development there which are being used, for example, by the Survivor film series. So that will remain in the province of Camarines Sur even if the location is outside, unless the new province offers a fair price and it is acceptable to the mother province.
Oh, okay. And where would the new province get the money for that fair price?
Oh, they will have to generate their own resources.
Uh-huh.
They will have to evaluate whether it's economically sustainable.
Mm-hmm.
It will all depend upon the new province.
And where again is Camarines Water Sports Complex?
It will be in Pili, and it will remain. It's in the same. It will not be separated.
In the old province in Camarines.
Yes, yes, yes.
Mm, okay. Congressman Fuentebella, so earlier we were saying no, yung bill, no, 4728 dati, ngayon 4820.
Sorry.
Yung legislative status niya, na-approbahan na siya, hindi po ba?
I'd just like to clarify this. Mm-hmm. It was approved, it was filed in May, it was approved on second reading in June,
mm-hmm.
and it was approved on third reading on August 3.
Uh-huh.
Contrary to the statement of Governor Ray that it was approved second and third reading in 1 week.
All right.
It was never reloaded. We have here a copy of the minutes
uh-huh.
where Governor Ray and even Congressman Fortuno, the lone oppositor of that bill, extensively participated in the committee hearings
mm-hmm.
where they made the rhetorics during mm-hmm. that day. It was a 3-hour debate that ensued where okay. many congressmen participated.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Like you said, it was approved on August 3rd, no? Not August 5th.
Right.
August 3rd, on a vote of impressive, what, 229-1?
To one. In the committee, C-Fortuno.
C-Fortuno.
He even stood up to clarify.
District siya? Anong district po siya?
Fifth district. Uh-huh. In the committee, it was 22-6. Mm-hmm. 22 committee members voted in favor mm-hmm. of the creation of the province of Nueva Camarines, and only 6 opposed.
Who were the 6 who opposed? Would you
well,
remember?
One, Fortuno was one among them, mm-hmm. and the other congressmen were Congressman Ocampos, Congressman Biron, mm-hmm. Congresswoman Plaza, I forgot the others. Mm-hmm.
Is dividing a province or carving out a new province from an existing one of the easier measures, legislative measures to pass in the House? Diba? The, I mean, you know, minsan pakiusapan na lang eh. Sige na, aprubahan mo na
yung bill ko. It's not that easy, Piyano. No? Because pursuant to the Constitution and the local government code, there are strict compliance requirements. Mm-hmm. Before you can even present a bill for consideration by the committee, there are provisions which says that you have to comply with the mandatory requirement on income mm-hmm. of net less than 20 million pursuant to 1991 CPI or Consumer Price Index, and a minimum population of 250,000 mm-hmm. plus or a land area of no less than 2,000 square kilometers. Mm-hmm. These provisions are not easy to comply. Mm-hmm. Plus a proviso which says that an existing province must not be reduced. Once mm-hmm. created a new province, the original mother province must not be reduced to the minimum required by the local government.
But okay.
And the other one, and the last one, as provided for in Section 8 of the local government, says, provided further, that the income classification of the mother province must not be reduced.
Mm-hmm. But what I also meant by that question was, you know, how easy, you know, people have this impression that it's very easy to get your fellow congressman to approve your bill. Yung
I think, Pia, if the bill complies with all the requirements, no, it mm-hmm. starts from the constitutional requirement that mm-hmm. any division must assure that there will be economic viability for both provinces. Mm-hmm. There would be administrative efficiency. Mm-hmm. and capacity to deliver basic services. Mm-hmm. And given the principles enunciated in the Constitution, the local government code prescribes specific mandate on what to do. Mm-hmm. And it has to have certain income requirements, population requirements, land area requirements. And that since Camarines Sur is a first-class province, based on the benchmark of the Department of Finance, the division must not result in reducing the classification of the mother province mm-hmm. to a say, second class. It must remain first class. Mm-hmm. But fortunately for this division, both provinces will end up to be first class.
First class,
first class in spite of the fact that some or many of the towns are poor.
No. Yes. Yes. Now the test is the what is the minimum income that will result, and the mm-hmm. Department of Finance has prescribed 450 million mm-hmm. in this okay. particular case. Well, we have yeah. more than enough for both.
The mother province will have an income of 773 million mm-hmm. and the new province will have an income of 591, way above the benchmark of mm-hmm. 450 billion.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
That these figures are certified by the Bureau of Local Government Finance.
Oh, this won't be the end, of course, because the Senate still has to vote on this. No, what are your reports? Huh? There are some sketchy reports that senators frown on this bill.
Well, to the senators you have talked to, they are going for it.
Mm-hmm. And who promised you that they will go for it?
Well, I don't want to enumerate their name, but nobody that I've talked to said they would vote against. They're all in favor.
Okay. Because when El Rey was here, he was also saying the same thing, no? Na i-oppose daw ng mga senador.
I don't think so.
I just stated things. Because when El Rey came here, he was saying something like, I filed this bill because I have a political agenda.
Yes,
I just want to clarify, I have no personal or political agenda.
Mm-hmm. What do you mean by that?
I do not have any plan mm-hmm. to run for governor. Neither have I even dreamt about it. Mm-hmm. Number two,
So in 2013, sir, babalik po kayo sa Kongreso?
No, this is my last
your
term.
Your last term na. Okay.
I intend to rest, to take a rest.
Okay. Your wife or any of your children will take over?
As I did in 2001.
Okay.
When my term first ended, I took a sabbatical.
Uh-oh.
And went to Harvard for executive courses at Kennedy School. In 1987, after our stint with Louie in the Batasan, I took a rest until 1992.
Mm-hmm.
So there's no sense pursuing.
Yeah.
Because I have reached the pinnacle of my career. I became speaker. Why do I have to fight for this?
So none of your children, like Wimpy, for example, will go back to Congress?
I don't know, because it's our leaders who decide who would run.
Yeah.
But at the proper time, we will decide on that.
Okay. But, you know, the question din kasi here is, kaninong mapupunta yung Nueva Camarines? Kaninong fiefdom yon? Kaninong kingdom yon? Sa Fuentebella?
Nalabas kay claim, number one, because my district, in terms of voting population, the fifth district has more voting potential than us.
Mm-hmm.
It has 17,000 more voters than my district.
Mm-hmm.
So, it's not an added advantage to Fuentebellas, to say so.
Mm-hmm.
But we included that because, just to briefly inform you, this creation of a new province for the Cabarelli de Sur stemmed way back during our Batasan days with Louie.
Mm-hmm.
Congressman Louie and I, and then my
late... As in IBP?
Yes.
Interim Batasan, yeah. Pampansa.
In the early 80s, we discussed this with my father, who was then the governor.
Mm-hmm.
Because we thought that really, Camarillo is really a very big province,
mm-hmm.
with 35,000 two cities.
Mm-hmm.
Can you imagine the magnitude, the size of Camarillo?
Yeah.
So it is twice as much as the province of Albay.
Yeah.
And you combine the province of Ilocos Sur and Ilocos Norte, that is Camarillo. Okay.
You're saying there is no political agenda whatsoever in either of your plans. You know, you are doing this purely for the benefit of Camarines Sur and
it started way back in the interim Batasan Pampansa. It did not push through because of circumstances that transpired. We were overtaken by events.
Mm-hmm.
And then, as can be gleaned in the Supreme Court decision on Navarro et al. Versus Ermita, just recently came out, promulgated by the Supreme Court April 2011, it cited the excerpts of the committee of the bicameral conference where the late Congressman Ciriaco Alfilor stated for the record that the four assemblymen at that time, Louie, Congressman Rolly Andaya Sr., Congressman Seya, the late Congressman Seya, and Alfilor, all planned to divide the province into two.
Mm-hmm.
So this idea of dividing or coming up with a new province has long been thought of.
But
not just now.
Yeah, precisely the point na parang nasanay na yung tao sa ganito na kapag gusto ng politiko na i-divide yung probinsya, para hindi lang ikaw ang hari dito, hindi lang ikaw yung gobernador dito.
Pia, if I may interject, you know, the division of Camarines Sur, whether we call it ironically or significantly, will result in the unification of the squabbling political leaders throughout the last three decades.
Yeah. When you say Fuentebellas,
you know, right now,
except for El Rey.
Yes, except for El Rey.
So everybody
has
against
joined.
El Rey.
You know what? You know what happened here now? The Fuentebellas are for it. The Alfilors, with whom the Fuentebellas have been contending, they are in the other part of that new province.
Before martial law,
are now for it.
Mm-hmm.
The Andayas are for it.
Mm-hmm.
The Chidato Arroyo will be for it.
Mm-hmm.
The Rocos have signed up in favor.
Mm-hmm.
And then I think even Secretary Jesse Robredo will soon announce support for the division.
Mm-hmm.
So only El Rey will remain, and many are signing up. You know, originally, the presidents of the Mayor's League, Vice Mayor's League, Councilor's League, Barangay League are all on the side of El Rey. Now the overwhelming majority are now in favor.
Okay.
Yeah,
he will be abandoned.
All right.
We have 24 mayors right now supporting the measure.
How many towns?
24 out of 35.
Okay.
And then 24 vice mayors out of 35, and 21 ABC presidents altogether, plus a majority of the barangay captains and barangay kagawan.
Yeah, these are officials, but of course, if or when the Senate approves this, President Aquino signs it into law, may plebiscite pa ito.
Yes,
so
yes,
you're
going,
you are convinced that you will be able to convince the people of Camarines Sur.
Yes, yes. I think it's very important to emphasize, and I'm glad you pointed it out, Pia, that the function of Congress here is merely to recommend to the people. Even if a law is approved and signed by the president, it will be the vote in the plebiscite that will determine whether it will become effective.
Congressman Villafuerte, I wanted to ask you this now. If you and El Rey were on good terms, would this proposal have seen the light of day?
Yes, certainly.
No, even if you were on good terms, huh?
Whether we are on good terms or not. Mm-hmm. You know, we have been talking about this for years, honestly. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And I have served the longest as governor, please remember that. Mm. And El Rey would say that, why did I not complain when I was serving the entire province and why am I now for the division? Mm-hmm. You know, I was elected to a big province, why should I complain? But at the back of my mind, it will become more efficient and delivery of services will be effective. Yeah. Because the magic of division, even if there is some division even of the revenue pie, the per capita contribution per person will be higher because you have less people. Mm-hmm. The per capita expenditure to infrastructure will also be more. Mm-hmm. You know, this is the magic of of a division. And in fact, additional internal revenue allotments under the formula prescribed by law will be added.
Mm-hmm. And I have here a data on the table which shows that smaller provinces are more successful than the bigger ones. Mm-hmm. For instance, in the terms of ranking out of 79 provinces way back in 2008, can you imagine coming in ranks number one, it's one of the smallest, number two is Siquijor, number three is Caliga, Benguet, etc. Now, the big provinces fares quite low. Mm-hmm. In terms of good governance, out of 79, Masbate ranks number 76. Mm-hmm. And then Leyte, 77. Mm-hmm. Cavite del Sur is 78 of 79. Mm-hmm. And Maguindanao is 79. That's the last. Mm-hmm. That's the lowest. Mm-hmm. So you can imagine the thesis that Louis here propounded. There will be more effective and efficient delivery of services. Mm-hmm. For instance, because we are now reeling from sheer poverty in the province. What is the poverty incidence of Cavalisso right now? It's 47%. Mm-hmm. Can you imagine out of a population of 1,693,000, about 799,000 are poor?
You're saying the poverty incidence will go down once we have this new province?
I suppose so, because there will be more focused attention in the delivery of basic services. Mm-hmm. There will be more job opportunities. Mm-hmm. Because as found by the BLGF, it's very basic, and we have to determine that when a smaller province is a lot easier to manage. Mm-hmm. In the principle of management of expanding control, it's a lot easier. Yeah. There will be effective and efficient delivery of services. And we are now suffering from this. Can you imagine on the poverty incidence, 47%? And in terms of income, what's the income now of Cavalisso? Mm-hmm. Although the governor says it's one of the top 10, which is disputed because it's one of the top 10 richest provinces. How come that out of the total income Cavalisso include, because there are two sets of revenues, the IRA and the revenues generated by the province in terms of taxes, fees, and what have you. Mm-hmm. Okay. On the total revenues generated by the province, it's only 7%. 85% are dependent on IRA. Mm-hmm. Whether you work or not, you will get that. Mm-hmm. 7% is totally generated. Out of the 7%, only 4% are taken from real property taxes, and only 1% is relegated to social services.
Okay. Will the creation of this new province in any way impede development in terms of tourism? Because, I mean, after all, the water sports complex is doing so well, and you've got a one.
Well, this is the argument of El Rey, no? And his supporters, that it will derail the tourism program. But let's look at it. You know, El Rey has promoted two specific destinations. One is the wakeboarding as an anchor for his sports tourism development. The other one is an island development in Caramoan, which will be in the new province. Mm-hmm. You know, they will not be affected because, as I said, the wakeboarding is in the mother province and will remain. The one that's going to be on the other province will also remain, as proposed by me in my amendments. So what would be the effect?
Yeah.
But the real problem is that we should not anchor tourism development in Camarines Sur primarily on wakeboarding. That's not going to be sustainable for a long, long time. Mm-hmm. You know?
Okay.
And there are competitions coming up where other wakeboarding. I think we should expand the tourism development in Camarines Sur after the division into include agritourism, culinary tourism, pilgrimage tourism, adventure tourism, shopping tourism, medical tourism, to really get tourism going.
Okay. Oh, I just clarified.
And not rely on wakeboarding.
Before we get to the really juicy portion, we'll ask Kong Louis about father and son.
On tourism, the Public Finance Institute of the Philippines, headed by no less than the former secretary, Bobby De Ocampo, conducted a study. And what they found out, that the tourism alleged income, big income of Camarines Sur, is not producing or does not create jobs for the province. Why? The province, as stated in the NSCB report, is number 63 underemployment on data. And then it is number 44 out of 79 on unemployment. So you can imagine, they claim and advertise that tourism is good. We all like that. Why not? But the reality is the fact that the tourism has not generated employment. Whereas what we're saying, if you come up with a smaller province, it's a lot easier to develop, that easier to manage, and basic services will be delivered properly. For instance, we are suffering from the problem. We don't have any provincial hospital. On health services, we fare very poorly. On education, it's not commensurate. And then in terms of infrastructure, there are so many provincial roads that remain unpaved. And it hinders access to transportation of people and goods. So all of these taken together accounts for the fact that the large province is difficult to manage.
Okay, and you're saying in other words, Kong, na pag may bagong probinsya, pag may Nueva Camarines, masosolve yung mga problema na yan.
Not exactly solved, but we will be able to little by little come up with
good solutions. Yun ang ina-expect ng tao.
Yes, we have to.
Ba't pa kayo magsasubdivide ng kingdom nyo kung hindi naman kayo magde-deliver,
di ba? When I say, kasi ang point namin, it will bring greater benefits to the people in terms of jobs, services, health, etc.
Well, it should also be seen in the roads, di ba?
Yes.
In hospitals. Anyway, you know, we can't let you go without asking you this juicy bit. No? I'm sure people will not forgive us if we don't talk about it. Congressman Louis, ano ba talaga yung naging problema niyo ni Elray?
Well, number one, when I had finished my three consecutive terms as governor,
What year was that, 2007?
2004.
I
was the one who anointed him to be my successor.
He's your only son?
No, I have two.
Okay, he's the elder one.
No, he's the younger.
Younger, okay.
And I said, you try to be governor and, you know, we work hard for it, he won.
Okay.
Then 2 months later, he was telling the people there, then, you know, I'm now governor. It's not my father anymore, in spite of his commitment that
so he gusto niya magtanggal ng tao?
Hindi lang magtanggal, massive. Massive na mga taong tinanggal.
What is so bad about that? If he is the new governor, why
would
you take
that? But these are people who have been tried and tested. And they have been most helpful to me and to him. You don't do that in the next few months after you, you know. You have a plan of reorganization, determine the proper assignments. That would have been okay, you know.
See, at that point,
but
you
even
felt
permanent, you know, I feel very bad about it. And I told him so. But then he just ignored me and, okay, let him go. I did not interfere with him. Then comes the local elections. Now he says that he wants to decide on who the mayors, vice mayors, and councillors will be.
This is 2007.
2007. I said, hey God, you can't do that. These people have worked with us. They have helped us. We helped them. They are there. And they're still there. And the third round was during the time when I sponsored a bill for redistricting in Camarines Sur, you know, to give a seat back to Congressman Andaya, because Dato Arroyo was remember, yes, and he opposed it again, as he is opposing this now.
Yeah.
So the end result of that is that he did not win a single mayoral seat in the second district of Camarines Sur. No? And now here comes this proposed bill. He's now opposing it again. But ironically, he got his man to sponsor another bill to also redistrict.
Yung distrito po ninyo?
Oh. Okay. So, sabi, it's very inconsistent eh.
Okay.
Pag kami ang gumawa, he opposes it. But he wants to do something else, no?
It seems unusual lang eh. Nag-iisip ako ngayon eh, sino bang father-son political team na nag-aaway? Kayo lang eh.
Wala. Sabi nga ng isang columnist, ano raw eh. Kasi what's happening now is that, you know, I have announced this is going to be my last term as congressman. And I'm going to run for governor whether or not the province is divided. I discussed this with Nolly, you know?
And we will be together with it. Kung hindi matuloy yung division ng
provincia, still running for governor. And that if it's divided, I am running here in my
original
province. This is where I was born, this is where I grew up, and I observe also as a congressman and as a member of the Batasang Pambansa as well, no? So, but the unfortunate part of it is that all of a sudden, now Elda is saying that he wants to pit his son, my grandson, who is, 22 years old, will be 23, I think, 4 months before the elections in May of 2013.
Pit your grandson, his son, against you?
Against me.
Oh,
you know, that will go into the Guinness Book of Records.
Yes, definitely. Definitely. But so,
you know, it's our family is very saddened.
Yeah.
That this thing has been happening, we lament the fact that
you have tried to reconcile, no, sir.
Alain,
you did try to reconcile.
Oh, we
right?
tried many times.
Oh, but there was this. I hear there was this one big incident where you did try a major.
Yeah, my wife and my daughter were there one night. This it was reported that it happened during Father's Day a few weeks ago. No, it did not happen at that time. It was. Mm-hmm. It was earlier, before the elections. No, and we wanted to discuss with him and see if, you know, that we can prevail upon him to reconsider some of the things he was doing, because it was really dividing the group that have been with us for years and years, no? And that, you know.
Pinuntahan niyo siya sa bahay niya?
Yeah, pinuntahan ko sa bahay.
Ano nangyari?
I don't know if we should talk about it. Some
no, it's okay. We're talking about it. Ituloy niyo na.
Sabi kasi ng mga ano ko, huwag ko nang patulan yung nangyari ganun, because it's a very bad reflection on him, no? We lament the fact what he did. But, you know, the truth to tell, he was shouting at me, he was cursing me, pero... You know, so we just move out na lang para...
atras na lang kayo, para wala nang
violent. We have the permission of Louie.
Sige, sir.
Kasi it was published in the papers 2 or 3 days ago, that I was intervening, interviewed, taking advantage of it. While Louis here, I even attempted in 2007, when LA came to see me, asking for my support, I even tried to pass them up, father and son. And we made arrangements that the two of them will meet in Manila. And then whatever happened, they met, but I have nothing to do with what happened in the past.
Louis, I don't see, Nolly was the ally of El Rey in the last two elections. And now he's hitting him left and right.
All the smear campaign and, you know, character assassination. But Louis has been my political ally, but I told him, we might have been political ally, but it would be best for all of us. Father, so magkaintindihan sana kayo.
You know, we should. I need to say thank you and goodbye to the two of you, Senator. But I was just thinking, and I hope you will agree, Kong Louie, no? We should have one episode na magkasama kayo, pati si Eldrin.
Well, I don't mind
you
that.
You don't mind, di ba?
I don't mind that naman eh.
Huwag nila kasama siguro.
Father and son na lang.
Ang problema kasi, ang problema kasi is that, yun nga, you know, if this is the first time I'm going to talk about the so-called feud, quote unquote, no? I've never talked about it. He speaks publicly about it. I never even responded. No,
that's true.
But this must be very painful for you. I mean,
no, and for the rest of the family.
Okay.
My wife, all the rest of the brother and the sisters are all on my side. My brother are also on my side. You know. Yeah. Pero ayoko nang dumagdag kasi. Ano eh, you know, everybody has been saddened by this.
Yeah.
If someone in my family has gone astray, We just pray for him.
Astray.
We just pray for
loaded
him.
Loaded yun, loaded yun.
Sabi nga ng mga nangasawa ko, mga anak ko, let's just pray for him.
Yeah, okay. But you will agree to appearing with him. Let's try it.
No, but if we are going to appear to discuss this so-called family feud, I would rather not. I don't think so.
So you'd rather appear and discuss the new
problems? Kaya nga. Ako nga dito, we are discussing this division. Let's discuss the merits and demerits of it. No mudslinging, no muckraking, no.
So in other words, no ang sagot.
Alam mo naman ako, Pia, no? When it comes to debate, ako rin, I could be very aggressive also. This is a local issue that unfortunately Elray elevated to a national issue.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. No? Well, that's why we're talking about it on this show.
That's why I should think that if there's any debate, confrontation or whatever, let the people of Camarillo decide on this proposed partition.
Yes, because
all right.
As what we have been saying, let the people decide why he's afraid.
Okay, we are so over time. From gerrymandering to father and son squabbles. Maraming salamat po, Congressman Nolly Fuentebella and Congressman Luis Villafuerte. Okay. Thank you so much for joining us tonight.
Thank you very much, Pia.
When we return, we'll talk to Quezon Representative Danny Suarez about the proposal to split his province. Strictly Politics will be right back.